They say you can't pay for respect. Shit, but you can buy hate. My Nismo got gizmos in that driver's seat is Versace. I'm like, bitch, get in. She listen in. Just sit and speak, cause I'm about to make a motherfucker go sideways. 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 Go sideways. Sideways. Go sideways. Hey, bitch, my Nismo got gizmos in that driver's seat is Versace. I'm like, bitch, get in.
Notifications on.
Flying high like an aeroplane, drop harder than the towers, man. Dr. Manhattan, boy, call me a watchman. Yeah, because they watching, man, they watch me while I sleep. In the spy satellite, no, I levitate in my sleep. Meditation is the key.
Before the Pilgrim Fathers landed at Plymouth, we were here. Before Jefferson etched across the pages of history the majestic words of the Declaration of Independence, we were here. Before the beautiful words of the Star-Spangled Banner were written, we were here.
My question is this.
And that's some time, brother. We're going to keep it moving.
Does the attachment of the color black to power and nationalism undermine the copper-skinned indigenous Americans' recognition for their stolen land? And I'm defining this on the Noah Webster's definition in 1828 dictionary, which defines who the real American is, and not the European that attached themselves to that name. They knew who we were when we got here. Not all of us came over from Africa. So I want that question addressed.
Now, that was probably addressed to the students at the Harvard Law School. Is that right? Are you all ready? You ready?
Man.
Yeah, exactly. You didn't want to hear from me.
What I want to say is this. We got to, we in the teaching phase right now, and I don't know if you want, do you want to hang out in the lobby for a while?
Brother, I'll hold on until I drop.
Where you holding your bag?
My plane don't leave till 6 in the
morning. I can't work this man like this.
No, I came here to work now, so we're going to.
Okay, I would say this. We want to answer all the questions.
That's right.
And want to speak to all of y'all. I want y'all to meet Dr. West and whatever, but guess what? This has been such an awesome session. It has gone to the last hour. We're going to the last hour. I want to answer that question. The answer is no, number one. The answer is no. Us saying black power does not undermine the indigenous. I mean, that's the short answer. Now, let's get deeper into it. But the answer is no, only if we start talking about the land and how we're going to divide the land and we start dictating the terms on the land we don't own.
Oil? Who said something about oil, bitch? You cooking?
What you talking about?
I'm just the elephant in the room. What's your best excuse? I'm just the elephant in the room.
Do you really wanna be the one to make this so uncomfortable tonight? Yeah. When you could be the one to set the record straight, you think it's not the perfect time? I wish I could be the one to make it easy, but I remind you that you're gonna
wanna hurt some feelings. So you slide around the issues and lay low. Heaven forbid you gotta dirty up the halo. So I'm not gonna let this go. Don't know what you're waiting for. I'm not gonna let you go. So I'm just the elephant in the room. What's your best excuse? I'm just the elephant in the room. Better think this through. You don't wanna talk about your feelings. I'll be in the corner with the reason. I'm just the elephant. I'm just the elephant.
Credo was given a special headdress as a gift from Hopi elder, Grandfather David.
When I came to the United States of America, I was very afraid of the people known as the Red Indians. I had come with preconceived ideas of how these people looked like. I was expecting tall, wild savages with blood-red skins and long hair, the sort of rubbish that we are shown in comics as to how Red Indians look like. I was very surprised to find not only were these people not red, in fact, they were like our own Cape Coloureds and Hottentots in appearance. I found that they were my brothers.
As an Indian, because of African descent, why am I this color? Because this is the color of my ancestors.
Indian territories, tribes. Like, people be thinking Indians with the Pocahontas looking. That ain't how Indians look. They look like them people in New Orleans.
And all of them had each other's names tattooed on them. Man. And this was when I was younger, I didn't understand it, but then when I started going to New Orleans, like, you know, on tour and shit.
We tried.
The way they are with each other, they love each other a different way than everybody else.
We're gonna talk about the black Indians I met that are still alive.
No, go ahead, let's talk about them, go ahead.
In New Orleans.
Well, the truth to that lies with the anthropologists, if they tell the truth. Because as they dig into the grounds, they have found people and they know they look like I look.
A few weeks ago, a guy was digging a pool in his backyard in the downtown area of New Orleans. You see, New Orleans was small at one time and this area was country. And they hit 6 feet down, they hit a casket. I said, what's the casket doing here? It was a cypress casket. Cypress wood. Now, you know, when you dig down more than a foot or two in New Orleans, you're going to hit water. Cypress is a tree that's grown in a swamp. It's not rotten. This cypress casket has been good for a few hundred years. They found black Indians inside with black artifacts, Indian ash artifacts. Okay? They went, they said, well, let's dig north instead of that right here. They went north, the casket. South, hit them. East, hit them. West, hit them. We found that there's a graveyard, an ancient graveyard, that's almost a mile in north, south, east, and west, almost a mile apart, almost. And they found out that since when they weren't able to go any further laddering, like we did graves, they started digging down, one on top of the other. And they have found, so far, 20,000 graves, black Indians.
Wow.
Okay, and this is about to hit. It hasn't hit. This happened a few weeks ago. You haven't heard on the news yet, but it's going to hit the news because it's going to leak out. They're hushing it right now.
80s. We are now going to call ourselves African American. And a lot of people just said, well, who are they to decide what we're going to call ourselves now? And it felt at first like a step backwards because black really was a big catch-all, but also so powerful.
It's our dream to go to our homeland where our roots are.
The African American.
Among African American and
African American people.
African American.
African American.
African American.
Why don't you like using African American, by the way?
Because as I trace my roots back in this country, the majority of my roots, the ones that are more meaningful to me, were the slaves that were my foreparents, my forefathers.
We don't call them European Americans. So I don't want to be called an African American. I'm an American.
Correctness, African American. I'm not African. I'm American.
You know what I'm saying? You can call me a black American, but I'm an American.
And so I identify as a black American, more so than an African American.
I've been an African American. We're not from Africa. We're black.
The stuff that Afro-Americans had in the 60s and the 50s, we sold it all for equal treatment, which means we gave up our economic power just so we can drink from a white man's water fountain. Think about how stupid this shit is. Every nation, China come over here, Asians come over here, they have stability. In our country, Africans come over here, they have stability. In our country, where all of that shit is falling apart.
Letters and Notes on the North American Indigenous People of North America, written in 1841 by author George Cartland, a noted ethnographer, describes American Indigenous People of North America as: all primitive tribes known in America are dark copper colored with jet black hair, while most possess curls in the extreme, which today is considered nappy hair, and every level of wavy hair in between. The texture of the hair is generally fine, soft or silk, or coarse and harsh. Catlin also noted, the hair of the men falling down to the hams and sometimes to the ground is divided into plaits or slabs 2 inches wide and filled with a profusion of glue and earth, which becomes very hard and remains unchanged from year to year. Today, this form of hair is called locks and filled with a profusion of glue and earth, which becomes very hard and remains unchanged from year to year. Today, this form of hair is called locks.
Lived in an environment that they were breathing liquid oxygen. They lived in a forest, a canopy, and the air that they were breathing, that's why you might see that the people hair was straight. Their hair was always wet. Look at the environment. Look at maps.
1895 and 1896, when a lot of the whites found out the benefits that these blacks are going to be entitled to, a lot of whites went to the Dawes Commission and say, look, why don't you put my name on there? They said, but you're not an Indian. They said, I'll give you $5. So the rule got around, the posse got around that if for $5 that a white could put his name on the dog's rolls and be called himself an Indian and be entitled all these benefits, and all their children could be entitled all these benefits forever. And so that became known as what's called a $5 Indian. And so if you go around now and check most of the Indians, the so-called Indians in America, about 90% of them are not even Indians. Those are just whites now who are passing as Indians. And but they're getting all the benefits. And they're not paying any taxes, getting free college education. They put up a little reservation on the land that they don't live on. They have another home off and get all kind of benefits.
Only we're not African Americans. We're indigenous. An African American is Obama. Why? Because his mother's European and his father's Kenyan. That's an African American. A real Indian, American Indian, is me. Both of my parents are American Indians, not from Africa.
Slaves, baby. Indians enslaved because we lost the war. So we assimilated into the United States. Real Indians look like us. Ask Christopher Columbus who he saw when he got off the ship. Let him know when he reported to a king. Why you think you got a brown penny, baby? Copper color Indians, baby.
What do you think about Black Lives Matter?
Black Lives Matter has nothing to do with the original Black American Indians. Black Lives Matter is a propaganda to keep blacks thinking that they're African Americans that came on slave ships. We already know we are waking our people up to let them know that we are the American Indigenous Indians. Black Lives Matter do not represent our people. We do. Jesse Jackson do not represent our people. Barack Obama do not represent our people. Only we're not African Americans. We're indigenous. An African American is Obama. Why? Because his mother's European and his father's Kenyan. That's an African American. A real Indian, American Indian, is me. Both of my parents are American Indians, not from Africa.
Black History Month, you find?
Ridiculous.
Why?
You're going to relegate my history to a month?
Oh, come on.
What do you do with yours? Which month is White History Month?
Well,
come on, tell me.
I'm Jewish.
Okay, which month is Jewish History Month?
There isn't one.
Oh, why not?
Yeah.
You want one?
No.
I don't either. I don't want a Black History Month. Black history is American history.
They say you can't pay for respect. Shit, but you can buy hate. My Nismo got gizmos in that driver's seat is Versace. I'm like, bitch, get in. She listen in. Just sit and speak, cause I'm about to make a motherfucker go sideways. Sideways. Go sideways. Go sideways. Hey, bitch, my Nismo got gizmos in that driver's seat is Versace. I'm like, bitch, get in. She listen in. Just sit and speak, cause I'm about to make a motherfucker go.
I'm gonna be the darkest secret that you can't forget and keep back in your mind. So when people ask what's wrong with you, you can't explain what's killing you inside. I don't know why you gotta cheat on what you stand for. You try to look away, but I'm so big they ignore. I can lay off if you say so. A guilty conscience is obnoxious with no pedal. So I'm not gonna let this go. Don't know what you're waiting for. I'm not gonna let you go. So I'm just the elephant in the room. What's your best excuse? I'm just the elephant in the room. Better